This video will discuss Chapter 5.3, Solving Multi-Step Inequalities. First problem we're going to work on looks like this. So keep in mind that we're focusing on when we should and should not flip the sign. And the goal is to isolate the variable. So I want to get the y by itself. So the first thing I'm going to do is add 13 to both sides. And again, like we talked about in class, it may make sense to try to do the sign first. So if I'm adding 13, I'm not multiplying or dividing by a negative number, so the sign is going to stay the same. This will cancel out, and I've got negative 11y is greater than 55. Now, from there, I'm going to, again, try to isolate the variable, so I want to get the y by itself. So I'm taking the coefficient, or the number in front of the y, I'm dividing that to both sides. The number in front of the y is negative 11. Okay, remember that this is my divider for the signs, or for the sides. Since I'm dividing by negative 11, and negative 11 is a negative number, the sign is going to flip. So now it's going to be facing that way. Negative 11 divided by negative 11 gives me positive 1y. And then 55 divided by negative 11 is negative 5. So my final answer is y is less than negative 5. Again, if I'm going to write this in proper notation, it is for all values of y is less than negative 5. Again, if I wanted to check my answer, I could do that. Take a number like negative 6, negative 7, negative 8, something that is less than negative 5. You put that in here. Let's just say negative 6. I get 66. Minus 13, 66 minus 13 is positive 50. 50 is greater than 42, so that checks out. All right, so that's basically kind of like two steps to solve that problem. Another type of problem might be this one. Okay, so this is obviously going to be a few more steps. So the first thing I got to do is eliminate the parentheses, right? So I need to do the distributive property here, and this becomes 12t. That should be a minus. Minus 4 times negative 5, that is minus 20, plus 7, greater than or equal to 8t plus 3. Okay, now what I want to do is combine like terms. And so I'm looking to combine these two. And so I now have 12t minus 13 is greater than or equal to 8t plus 3. Okay, and so then, now, there's a bunch of different ways I can solve it. Personally, I'm going to try to get the t on the left and the number on the right, so I'm going to end up subtracting 8t from both sides. This is not necessarily the step that you have to do next. Subtract 8t. Okay, again, if I'm dealing with the sign first, since I'm subtracting, I'm not multiplying and dividing by a negative number, so that's going to stay. So I got 4t minus 13 greater than or equal to, this cancels out, and that's a 3, right? And then I'm going to add 13 to both sides. And again, sign won't change. And so this is now, this cancels out, so I've got 4t is greater than or equal to 16. And then I need to take the number that's in front of the t and divide that to both sides. Okay, I'm going to end up writing my solution over here. Since I divided by 4, but 4 is a positive number, the sign does not change. And so I should get t is greater than or equal to 4. Right now, I unfortunately ran out of space, so I'm not going to write the proper notation. Ideally, you at this point, you're getting comfortable writing it the proper way. If I wanted to check my answer, I'm taking a number that is greater than 4, so say like a number like 10, and I could substitute 10 in to both places up here and make sure that this actually works. But what I want you to notice is on this particular problem, the way we solved it, or the way I solved it, I did not flip the sign, right? The sign never actually changed. There would be ways that you could. For instance, if you subtracted 12t from both sides and then ended up subtracting 3, you would actually have to flip the sign. But you should get the same answer, flipping it or not. All right, now let's talk about a couple of special circumstances. So we'll start with this one. And again, the first thing I got to do is the distributive property. So this is going to become 9h, it's an h minus 5h plus 25, negative 5 times negative 5 is positive 25, less than or equal to 4h minus 12. Okay, and I'm going to take these like terms and I'm going to combine them. So I now have 4h plus 25 greater than or equal to 4h minus 12. Okay, now at this point, some of you may see a problem that's arising. If you don't, you want to pause the video and try to examine it, you can. If not, keep watching. We're about to kind of figure out what the problem is. But next thing I would probably do is subtract 4h from both sides. So I'm going to take 4h from here, 4h from here. Okay, sine is going to stay because I'm subtracting. This goes away. So I'm left with 25 and negative 12. So my problem is, well, two things. One, the h's are gone, so I got rid of the variable. And two, this statement is actually not true, right? 25 is not less than or equal to negative 12. So if you get to the point where you either eliminate the variables or you get a statement that is not true, it means there is no possible answer, right? That's the empty set. Now, what I want you to notice is you do not put the fancy parentheses around the empty set, right? So those are not going in there. The empty set kind of stands by itself. Keep in mind, it's not a zero. It has that slash, right? But so if you get to a point now here where this is not true, it's the empty set. Now, some of you may know the next example that's coming. So I'm going to kind of go quickly through the distributive property part of this. And so I got 12m plus 18 less than or equal to 42 plus 12m minus 24. Okay, and then when I combine like terms on the right side, I should get 12m plus 18 is less than or equal to 12m plus 18. Now, this one seems probably a little more obvious what my problem is, but then the next step would probably be to subtract 12m. And so these two cancel out, so I'm left with 18 is less than or equal to 18. Now, this is where a lot of people end up making a mistake, because this is actually a true statement. Because this number has to be less than or equal to this number. It doesn't have to be both. In fact, it can't be both, right? So it's either less than or it's equal to this number, and 18 happens to be equal to 18, obviously. So if that's true, this is where you get all real numbers. And again, you do not need to put this inside of a fancy parentheses. You can just write the three words, but this is all real numbers because any number will work. And if you wanted to check it, you could take any number you want for m, substitute it in there, and this statement would be true. All right, so that's all we got for you today from solving multi-step inequalities. Don't forget to do the problems on the bottom of the page. Thanks for watching the video. See you in class.